Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kate. And I'm sweating because I've just been playing football at a back garden with the girls. I beat them bad. Well, no, don't know about bad. They give me the runarounds now. Look at my hair, look, sticking up everywhere. They give me the runarounds nowadays, they do. Right, get on with it. First, you'll see where this ties in. Lovely big book here, beautiful big lovely book. That one there, a fantastic book called The Brewmaster's Table from Garrett Oliver. Really well written book. It's fantastic. Hold on a minute. I've got one. Sorry, I'll just let the kids finish shouting and cheering. Right, fantastic book. And here's the brewmaster at Brooklyn Beers, and I try to stick my reviews to the kind of British beers, because I don't think they're getting enough coverage among the reviews and that, so I'm trying to kind of stick to them. But I've been sent these down. I've been sent a couple of, like, I got the Hawaii one that was lovely. I got another Brit one that was the Norfolk one there, that was the Panther. But I got this one, this is the Brooklyn Lager. The old Brooklyn Lager. So we're going to whack that one open and see how we go. Let's go. Oh, let's do it. Do me trick, look. Yay! Caught it a bit in the middle, but there you go. Right, Brooklyn. There's the little pretty Brooklyn cap there. Lovely. Very tastefully done. I like that. And it's that's nice. See, now, I've kind of had it in the neck for a long while for lagers, but there are some lagers that, you know, some of the bottom feeders are good boys, you know, some of the lagers are really nice. And I'm hoping this one's going to be one of those. They're not all lagers are Popsy McLagers, you know the kind of rubbish that you kind of fed from your teens and that, you know, from when you first start drinking. That's what it looks like. A kind of fairly plain but slightly hazy, but that's quite often a good thing. Let's have a sniff. I'm getting tangerines, I'm getting kind of kumquats. That's a posh one, isn't it? I'm getting them little fistless things, and I'm getting a kind of orange zest in there. All those citrusy notes that you get. Right, let's have a taste. Bottoms up. Cheers, Dave, by the way. Cheers. Oh, that's a pleasure. See, now if you taste that and put it next to any lager, that I think is one that I always sing the praises of is the Utenos one, but that's a kind of biscuity notes and all that. It's a really rich sort of lager, really lovely. And maybe the black lagers, like Pivovar Black and things like that. But that one will hold its own with anything. That is a beautiful lager, it really is. Stick that one next to, stick a bottle of that, right? If you see that around, stick a bottle of that next to your Popsy McLagers. You know, all those, you know the ones I mean. I ain't going to mention names and that, because I can't afford the lawsuit, you know, but stick them next to all your Popsy McLager rubbish and everything else. Have a taste of that, and then taste your rubbishy, gas-filled, you know, fire extinguisher lagers. I love that description that Simon had of the fire extinguishers going off with the, I think it was a Foster's he had. I love that description. But you put that next to one of them, and it's a lager. You know, so I think the old description of lagers is that they was kind of lagered. There was beers that was lagered, that was kind of cold stored in it, you know. But this one is, lagers nowadays is kind of to do with the yeasts more than anything. You got bottom feeder yeast, top feeder yeast is most of the other, is the other beers, the owls and all that. Right into porters and stouts and everything else. And then you've got the bottom feeders, what I call the bottom feeders. And it's usually kind of my term of abuse for lagers, but some of the bottom feeders are quite nice, you know. And this is one of them. Very rarely, for some reason, are the bottom feeders nice, but occasionally, if you've got some good malts going on there with them, and some good hops, then they're pretty cool. Quite often it's a Saisop, which I've never liked the Saisops. You know, I've never been mad keen on it, because it's just like papery thin, you know, you can punch an hole through it with flicking a finger, you know, it's the, that kind of taste. There's nothing much going on with a Saisop. I could be wrong, people would disagree, excuse my picking my bugle here. People will disagree, but this one, I don't know, there's maybe like Amarillos and things like that in there. It's certainly nice jazzy hops and not like, you know. That's a really jumping, jazz playing kind of a jazzy beer. You know, you could imagine listening to it, you know, that sort of thing. You know, so you know when you listen to a shell, you can almost hear the hops kind of playing a bit of the old trad jazz sort of stuff. Right, so let's whack that down, a little bit more tasting, and a big cheers. Yeah, plenty of orangey notes in there. Warm, warm orangey notes. Kind of like a warmed up orange. A big blood orange. One of them big blood oranges. Nice sweet notes. Really nice. It's a lovely beer. Once again, you're on a winner there. David, brilliant stuff, mate. This has been me, Terry Kay. Really enjoying a nice beer that that a good friend has sent down to me. Absolutely fantastic. Listen, before I just finish that last bit off, it is really, really a pleasure for me going on and kind of having a chat with all you, like, kind of all the people that are watching my reviews and that. It's lovely having a chat because everyone seems to have their own opinions of beers and things like that, and it's so lovely to just be able to talk about something that is a communal pleasure. It's a kind of a pleasure that you can all share. Don't matter where you are in the world, you can share that pleasure with each other. That is such a real a lovely thing that you can just sit and see, now and again I'll sit and watch someone else's review and I'm, oh yeah, blah blah, and I'll tap away and I'll do exactly the same thing. So to all the people that are out there and regularly comment and, you know, regularly watch, to all the subscribers and friends out there as well, a big cheers to you, a big cheers to you as well, David, Mr. Grim Viking. Oh, pardon me, a big burp to him as well. Watch his reviews as well, because he's a bit of a superstar. Fantastic stuff. Thank you very much, David. A brilliant beer. Good choosing, mate. Cheers.